Yo, what up, y'all? Welcome back to OTB. T-Off and Jake hanging out with you this morning, Tuesday at 7:30. You already know what it means. Let's talk to Coach O, the head football coach of your LSU football Tigers. Coach, we gave him last week off. He was down there in Florida with the boys, recharging the batteries before the final push to the season. 53 days away, Coach. How are we feeling?
53 days. That's a pretty good number, that T-Bob.
It's a damn good number, Coach. Damn right. I love Sony Finua. Real talk. I mean, Sony Finua, Coach, he was, I mean, you go ahead and tell the people, he was one of the best performers in spring.
Yeah, no question. But, you know, I had a great time in Destin, a great time with the boys, but it's good to be back. We had our football school yesterday. Great to see our team. Our team is in excellent shape. Tommy Moffitt and his strength staff has done a tremendous job with our team, and our team has done a tremendous job fostering leadership throughout the summer. You can see the leaders coming up. We had a players-only practice yesterday. Our guys look in fantastic shape.
Yeah, and we'll get into players-only practice. Football school's back as well. But first, we're going to be heading to Alabama next week. It is SEC Media Days. What days
are you
there? Monday. Okay, yeah. Y'all are kicking things off on Monday. We'll be there as well. Talk a little bit about Media Days, or let the people know who will be representing LSU in Alabama next week.
Yeah, very proud, Joe. One can bring two. I wish I could bring five. It's a neat day, T-Bob. As you guys know, Jake, you know, we get to fly on the private plane.
Yep.
We get to get together. Many a time, it's the first time they flew on a private plane. It's good to see guys do that. But this year, we're bringing Derek Stingley and Austin Deaconess, two great leaders. Obviously, Derek coming to LSU was big for us. He had committed to us, decommitted, gave some time off. His dad was very instrumental in helping us recruit Derek. He wanted his son here. His mama wanted him here. Corey Raymond did a great job. And Derek is the finest corner in America and also a great leader for us. So I can't wait to bring him. Then Austin Deaconess, think about the job he's done. He was very instrumental in helping me recruit the offensive line to come back this year. I think that's probably the biggest key to our season is having that offensive line coming back. So I'm very proud to bring both of those guys. They can represent LSU in the best way possible, I know.
Well, and you mentioned the offensive line, Coach. Deaconess leadership needed in more ways than one, because obviously with the Darren news, we already talked about it, right? Cam Wire slots in potentially right there at left tackle, but it's after that when it's interesting. And some of these younger cats are going to have to step up. They're going to have to develop. That goes on Brad Davis's plate as well. What is how is that process coming along in terms of trying to find answers and who will kind of grab that opportunity?
Next man up. You know, we have I'm very impressed with Garrett Dellinger. Garrett has come in here as a mid-year graduate. He's tough. He's strong. He's smart. He's handled everything we could give him. Anthony Bradford's turn. Step up.
Yep.
Step to the plate. You know, those guys are all going to have opportunity. But, again, you've got to go through a camp. As you guys know, it's coming up. Here's what I tell the team. You and Jacob know this very well. Summer training gets you ready for camp. Camp gets you ready for football. So we're not there yet. We just prepared for camp. Now the grinds of camp are coming. Let's see who can handle it. Let's see who can handle the grinds of playing at a top-notch level in the SEC. That remains to be seen. These guys are going to have to step up.
All right, Coach, since T-Bob went offensive line, I'll go running backs. There's a couple of young freshman running backs on campus that I'm excited about, and they're getting an opportunity to learn from one of my heroes growing up, Kevin Faulk, one of the best to ever do it in college football. So how is that going so far for those young freshmen running back with Coach Faulk?
Look good. You know, first of all, I want to say what a job Kevin Faulk has done for us. You know, for him to come back and to coach at his alma mater, LSU. You know, we had the deal in Grand Isle with Ben Bartolo and Alan Fonica, and all those great players were there, and they were excited that we were there. They were excited to see one person. It wasn't me. It was Kevin Faulk. And they see Kevin. And, you know, but Kevin's done a great job for us also in recruiting. Think about the Lafayette area. Him and Corey Raymond, Sage Ryan, Jack Beck, Malik Neighbors, several commits this year. These guys are doing a tremendous job recruiting. And then Kevin went to Ohio to get Corey Conner. He went to Alabama, and Marty Gilbert could have went anywhere he wanted to in Alabama. Got him. So not only a great job on the coaching aspect, but a great job of recruiting. So we're very pleased with the job Coach Falk has done. The running backs, I think Tyron Davis, Jake is in the best shape he's been. I seen him yesterday. He's the first guy that came to see me when I came back. He's about 230 pounds. John Emery's having his best semester in the classroom right now. He has some academic work to do, and he's very close. We're very pleased with him. Then you got Josh Williams, Corey Conner, and Amani Goodwin. And then Nick Davis. Nick took some snaps in the spring, can play, and Karen Norman. So Kevin has developed that running back group, a defined group.
Coach, so you get back, like you said, you get back a couple of days ago or yesterday. Guys, Tyron Davis, probably some other guys stopped by. How did football school go after a little time away?
Really good. You know, we had a lot of coaches were on vacation. About half of the coaches came back. The guys were really good. As you know, it rained yesterday, and that humidity was about 100% when we went out on the field yesterday. So, to me, it was perfect. I loved it.
Yeah.
And it was challenging. And we went out there, and we did some drills for about 25 minutes, and then our guys had their own football school. But they look sharp. I'm going to tell you who looks good, those young receivers. What I'm hearing from the quarterbacks, they're catching the ball, and they are very, very impressive.
Real quick, Coach, on those receivers, it just seems like now with the way that everything's set up and the way that 7-on-7 and the way that these offenses are really run in high school and they transition to the college level, like you can now play as a true freshman at that position, because I remember when I was coming in, like it didn't really matter how talented you were. There was just a learning curve that it was very hard for true freshmen to play with the side adjustments and different things. But now you've got these guys coming in. All they really know, Coach, is 7-on-7 and routes and coverages.
That's right. There's no more fullbacks on 7-on-7.
that brings tears to my eyes, Coach, by the way.
But yeah, they are at best. And the receivers coming in right now, they know the routes, they know the trees. And as you know, a receiver can get ready faster than anybody else. And these guys have tremendous skills. I love that. Since when we've gone to the spread offense, number one, we're able to track some of the best quarterbacks in America because of the spread offense. And number two, the receivers want to come because they know they're going to catch the ball.
Talking to LSU head football coach Ed Orgeron here on Off the Bench. Coach, you alluded to earlier a players-only practice. Now, obviously, for maybe those that don't know, this is something that was common before the 2019 year. These like Saturday morning practices were Cushenberry, Burrow, and all those other names, and have everybody out there. So what exactly is going on now with these player-led practices? How does that work?
Think about this. Four summers ago, we had a players-only practice. Maybe 25% would show up. Maybe 30. Right now, it's 100%.
Wow.
It's not even a question if you're going to be there or not. So those guys, they handle that. We can't take role, but those guys handle the team leader handle that. Now, what happens is they have individual, they have one-on-ones, they have 7-on-7, and then they have a team, and they go against each other. And it's all scripted. They have put together. And it's just like a practice that the coaches would be out there, but the leadership runs the practice.
Just one player that I want to ask you about, and you mentioned his name, and that was Jack Besh a little bit ago. Because a couple of weeks ago, we mentioned maybe trying to play some tight end, maybe play, in line a little bit. Obviously, he's a receiver, one of the best high school players in the last couple of years in the state of Louisiana. Is that still something that y'all can see for him, kind of going back and forth between receiver and tight end?
No question. You know, the same thing with a lot of the guys we're recruiting. A lot of guys we're recruiting. Jake, when you played a tight end with a bona fide tackle. Now a tight end is a guy that can stretch the field. A tight end is a guy that we can put an X, we can put a slot. He is a pass-catching tight end first and then a blocking tight end second. Now, if we can find a guy that can do both, obviously that's going to help us. But right now we're looking for the tight end that can stretch the field and we can go five wides and present the offensive problem.
Coach, something else that happened a couple of weeks ago that kind of represents a fundamental shift in college were the passages of the NIL laws, or at least them kicking in throughout the country. Obviously, LSU has been very forward-thinking on this front. I mean, an entire Times Square campaign. What's your view on how y'all are handling this kind of fundamental shift in college football?
Yeah, I think the athletic department did a great job. Scott Wilbur was ahead of it. He was ahead of the curve. He hired an outside consultant to help us. We've been very instrumental and aggressive in it since the beginning of it, keeping up the rules, when it's going to happen. You know, a guy on our staff, a lot of us there, but you guys, Eric's been on the radio, a lot of businesses. But I know a lot of our guys are having success with it. I kind of stay out of it. You know, if they need some help, I'm going to give them some help. But I'm for the players getting as much as they can legally, give it to them. They deserve it.
And then when it comes to getting ready for the fall, Coach, what is this next month? So obviously you got SEC Media Days next week, but what is kind of the next month looks like? We're just 53 days away.
You know, here's what I want to make sure that the guys are. We have a couple of guys with issues. They got to finish strong. That's number one. Number two is make sure that they're healthy. I don't want anybody getting hurt the next 3 weeks. Doing something stupid in the weight room, trying to squat about 850 pounds like you used to, something like that. But then go home, then go see their parents, get rejuvenized. Because when we come to camp, it's on. We report August 6th, so hopefully our guys can get about eight to 10 days off, do a little work on their own, come back fresh, ready to go.
Coach O, thank you so much, man. Every single Tuesday, I know you enjoyed the vacay, but I know you enjoy the grind as well. Back at it. We will talk to you again next week, Coach.
Hey, too much vacation, too many triple scoops. Talk to you guys.
Later, Coach. Huge thanks to Coach for coming on each and every week. Okay, a lot to dive into there.
I know you're so excited that a lineman's going to Media Day.
Well, I mean, you know, he's just following in my footsteps.
I know.
Not to brag.
Let me brag.
Only got in there because of a really, really incredibly stupid suspension by LSU compliance. But hey, you know what? Get it how you can, right? That was always my mantra. All right, closing up hour one. I want to talk about a lot of things that Coach O touched on right there. Close up hour number one. Keep it locked right here on Off the Bench.
Off the Bench with Hester and T-Bob.